The orphan situation in the world is at a critical point. There are now over 13 million AIDS orphans alone. This does not count the orphans that have been created by other illnesses and disasters. Zambia, in sub-Saharan Africa, has a population of only 10 million. But due to its high HIV infection rate, there are now 1 million orphans in Zambia. This is 1/10 of the population. Many of these orphans are cared for by their relatives, who take in nieces, nephews, and grandchildren into their already burdened households. This puts a huge strain on families in a country where only 4% are in full-time employment. What this means is that these children may not have the opportunity to go to school. Those who do may only reach the 7th grade and will thereby not have the chance to go on to a full and meaningful life. We've decided to open a center that will not only give these children the physical care they need, but the emotional and educational care. Every child deserves the chance to go to school, to fall asleep with a stomach that is full of good food, in a clean bed, and to have the chance to cherish thoughts of a bright future. With your help, we will be able to complete the vision we have of opening this center. We will be able to outfit it with the best equipment, the furniture, the toys and educational items that every child needs. With your help, we will give each child in our care the chance to go on to a better future. Join us now on our journey of making this vision a reality.
The first thing we had to do was to look for a place that was suitable for an orphanage. We found one in the northern part of Zambia in a place called Kazembe. It was an old hotel that had been abandoned for 20 years. It was grown up with bushes, shrubs, and trees. As we went and explored the building, it was like exploring an Aztec ruin which nature had completely taken over. After a few hours of surveying the property, we found that it contained over 30 rooms plus two other structures that could be used for a main house and cafeteria. So work began by cutting down all the trees that had grown out of the rooms. We hired the local people to help us with the task. Quite a bit of the rubbish and debris had to be cleared, ground leveled, retaining wall repaired, and bricks removed. Once that task was done, we built a natural grass wall around the property, not only for privacy, but also to protect us from snakes that were found locally. Then the real work began with the construction, reinforcing the walls, bringing in cement and skilled laborers. A lot of oversight had to be done as most of the workers were from the local village. There's no mountain too great. Hear the words and have faith. Oh, have faith. Windows and door frames are made from African teak, which grows nearby. We had to put on the roofs, and once this was done, we brought in the painters and electricians. An ablution block had to be built, and this is still under construction. We also researched and dug a large septic tank, which is fully complete now. Each of the rooms will be cemented with the local slate rocks that are found at nearby falls. A drilling company was contracted to drill on our property for water, as there is no city water available. Over 90 feet of pipe had to be drilled into the ground until we finally hit water. This was a two-day process. After drilling down 150 feet, we can now receive half a gallon of water per second, which is more than sufficient for our orphanage. A few more things are needed to complete this operation: a submersible pump, two tanks, and a tower. Still much more to do. He watches over.